Now, a 12% levy on internet data is among a raft of taxes that have been rolled out beginning today by the government. But business community, especially those whose operations are anchored on the internet, are crying foul, saying that the taxes should not be rolled out until after the lockdown has ended. Let's have the details in the following report.
Today, 1st July, marked the start of the new financial year 2021-2022. This also means implementation of all new taxes put in place by the government. Business people downtown Kampala say they are not against these taxes, but they have come at the wrong time. They say due to the lockdown, the taxes will further cripple their businesses and economy at large. MP for Bukoto Central, Richard Sebamala, says at such a critical time when businesses are down, government should instead consider giving a boost to people's businesses rather than collecting new taxes.
It is very absurd that a lot is going on in the country. People are sick, people are dying, people are hungry. There are very many, actually we are like in a crisis. Every family has lost a member or knows somebody that has lost a member. Today and now is not a time when we are going to start looking at taxes. This is a time when Parliament would be sitting with Cabinet, would be sitting and then telling Cabinet, making suggestions on which taxes should be used at the moment.
They have thus appealed to government to stay implementation of the new tax measures until the 42 days of the lockdown elapse. In Parliament, legislators are simply concerned that the new 30% property tax is going to burden already frustrated Ugandans who are struggling to pay rent.
Actually, it's very much disappointing that today Ugandans are earning nothing completely, but there are new taxes which have begun today and they are affecting Ugandans. Mm. Now, everyone is using social media and who have been paying OTT. Those who could not afford to pay OTT were using VPN. Today it's a must. Once you put on once you connect on social media, the taxes must be deducted, which is not so very convenient with the Ugandans.
The decision obviously is taken by government to have these taxes in place. Mm. And the same decision needs to be reviewed. Mm. How do we reconsider based on the situation right now? Because every situation has different kind of, you know, conditions attached to.
MPs are also concerned that tax on internet data will affect e-learning.
Sincerely speaking, this new tax, especially on the internet, especially in a period where we need information to move faster, should have been hindered, should have been delayed, because at the moment we need information, especially on COVID-19, to spread faster. But if you block it indirectly by the tax, because people cannot afford to facilitate for the taxes.
Such a time, if Parliament was open, then we would be able and would be in position to address such issues. In such a time whereby the country is in lockdown, taxes cannot start to be implemented. So we believe, and we quietly sure know, that this floor of Parliament should be open so that we can address the issues of national importance.
Senior economists, however, disagree. Their argument is these taxes were set before the lockdown and just a coincidence that they have become effective during this time.
The taxes are silent on COVID. For them, they were to come into effect on 1st of July. We all know they were set up before the lockdown started, but they are to operate for the whole year. So this is just that coincidence that they come in when the lockdown is on. But the beauty with some of these taxes is they are income-based. If you're not earning any income, then those taxes you don't have to pay them. Because some of them are like pay as you earn, which has not changed. Rental income, now already some landlords are not receiving rent.
Report by Jaliat Namoya and Fred Kajubi for the news in Kampala.